tuganire natwe.
Speak to us, dialogue with
us. May
your glory be in this place.
Mu izina rya Yesu.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Mushobora kwicara muri presence y'Imana.
May be seated in the presence of God.
Imana ishimwe cyane.
Praise God.
Kaduye Yesu amashini impundu nyinshi cyane muri iyo mwaka.
Let's give a hand clap of joy and a shout of joy to the Lord.
Ibyakozwe n'intumwa ibice bibiri.
Acts of Apostles chapter 2.
Umunsi wa Pentecote usohoye bose bari bari hamwe mu mwanya umwe bahuje umutima.
When the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all with one accord in one place.
Iki gice kirerekana ibyo Yesu yabasezeranyije.
This chapter is showing the fulfillment of what Christ had promised.
Iri jambo pante ni 50 birasobanura 50 50.
This word pent means 50.
Nukuvuga ngo nyuma y'iminsi 50 Yesu azamutse.
This means 50 days after the ascension of Jesus.
Yesu amaze gupfa.
When Jesus had died
no kuzuka
and rose again,
hashize iminsi 50.
50 days passed.
Niyo bita Pentecost.
That's what they call Pentecost.
Pentecost sukuzura umwuka we.
Pentecost is not the feeling of the Holy Spirit.
Pentecost ni iminsi 50.
Pentecost is 50 days
nyuma ya Pasaka.
After the Passover.
Nindi fete yakurikiraga.
It was the next feast coming.
Yakurikiraga nyuma y'iminsi 50.
It was going to come after 50 days.
Yari fete y'Abayuda yo gushima ko bejeje.
It was a Jewish feast of tabernacles.
Harvest. Bazaga bavuga ko bejeje.
They would come saying, "We have harvested."
Imana yabahaye ibiryo.
That God has supplied food.
Banezerewe.
And they are happy.
Rero abantu bavaga kure cyane.
So people travel from far.
Mu bihugu bitandukanye.
From different countries.
Muri Asia, muri Africa.
From Asia, from Africa.
Abo bazanwaga niki?
Why would they come to Jerusalem?
Bazaga muri wa munsi mukuru wa Pentecost.
They would come to this day of Pentecost, this feast of
Uyu
Pentecost.
Uyu munsi rero ugeze.
And so when this feast had come,
Yesu amaze kuzuka,
after the resurrection of Jesus,
yagize iminsi 40 ari kumwe n'abigishwa.
He spent 40 days with the disciples.
Muri iyo minsi 40,
in those 40 days,
yarimo ababwira iby'ubwami bw'Imana.
He was telling them about the kingdom of God.
Ndagira ngo murabyibuka mu byakozwe n'intumwa igice cya mbere.
I think you recall what he said in Acts chapter 1.
Hari yaruka yandikiye Theophilus.
Where Luke wrote to Theophilus,
kumurongo wa gatatu,
verse 3, chapter 1.
Amaze kubabazwa aboneka ari muzima atanga ibimenyetso byinshi agumya kubabonekera mu minsi 40 avuga iby'ubwami bw'Imana.
To whom he also presented himself alive together after his suffering by many infallible proofs, being seen by them during 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God.
Nuko bateraniriza hamwe abatega kutavi Yerusalemu ati ahubwo murindira ibyo data yasezeranije ibyo nababwiye.
And being assembled together with them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, "You have heard from me."
Yabateranyirije hamwe.
He assembled them together.
Yesu azutse.
When Jesus rose again,
yabahamagaye 11.
He called the 11 disciples.
Kuko Yuda yaramaze gupfa.
Because Judah had died.
Hari abandi bakurikiraga Yesu bitwaga abigishwa.
There were other followers of Jesus called disciples.
Abo ntibari muri babandi 12.
These were not numbered with the 12.
Aho harimo babagore nkaba Maria Magdalene.
That group included the ladies like Mary Magdalene.
Nabandi benshi bagendanaga nabo.
And other many followers.
Yesu abateraniriza hamwe.
So Jesus assembled them.
Ni hehe yabateranyirije?
Where did he assemble them?
Ha handi baririye Pasaka ijoro bari mu gambani.
The same place where he had his last supper in the night of his betrayal.
Harya niho bahuriye.
That's where they assembled.
Yesu arababwira ngo.
And Jesus said to them,
Kimuzava.
Do not depart from here.
Kugeza data bohereje kiva mu ijuru.
Until when the Father sends the promise from above.
Intego y'icyo data yohereza kiva mu ijuru ni iki kimaze iki?
What is the purpose of the Father sending the promise from above?
Kumurongo wa 8.
Verse 8.
Ngo muzahabwa imbaraga umwuka wera n'abamanukira mubabagabo bo guhamya.
But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me. In Jerusalem and all Judea, Samaria, and to the end of the earth.
bateranye.
So when they were assembled,
bari abantu basanzwe.
They were ordinary people.
Ba Petero b'abanyabwoba.
Peter the coward.
Ba Thomas bashidikanya.
Thomas the doubting man.
Ba Andrea bicekekeye.
Andrew the timid man.
Barya bose bari kumwe.
All of them were together.
Na karakteri zabo.
With all their characters.
Bari abantu basanzwe.
They were ordinary people.
Ariko
however, they needed something from heaven to indwell them so they can have power to speak what they were afraid to speak about, so that they will have power to do what they had failed to do before. What brings about signs and miracles? They come to convince that Jesus is there.
Donc ibitangaza bituma abantu bavuga ngo ibi bintu ni serie.
Miracles convince people and they will know this is truly God.
Donc intego yabo yari yihe?
So what was their purpose?
Kwari kugenda bahamya Yesu.
They had to go around witnessing Christ.
Hanyuma abantu bahindukire bakizwe.
So that people would be converted and get saved.
Ariko amagambo yabo gusa.
But they are normal words.
We
are not enough to convince people. And those who are to be convinced, they would be convinced in their mind but not in their heart. And so the Christianity of the intellect is very difficult. But true Christianity is within the heart. Because the intellectual Christianity is always questioning why. But the Christianity of the heart believes and accepts. It accepts, it believes what it hasn't seen. It accepts what it hasn't touched. That's how Christianity is. Of the inner heart, not outside
yes,
the man. So Jesus says, let me go. I have given you a lot of theories, but when the Holy Spirit comes, when he dwells within you, that which is seated in you, there's going to be a marriage between what is of the world and what is of heaven. That you will tell the people of the world to accept the things of heaven. But what is that thing? There shall come the power of God, which is the power of the Holy Spirit. I have lived with you, Jesus, in the flesh. In other words, I have lived with you. I was with you. I walked with you. But when I'm gone, I'll come back to you in another form. I'll come as a spiritual Jesus and indwell you. I'll not just be with you outside, but within you. I, the Jesus who healed the lame. When I dwell within you, you will heal the lame, but it's not you, it's me who is within
Yesu
you. The Jesus who opened the eyes of the blind
abantu
and people saw me.
Icho
at the time, they will not see me. I'll come in you spiritually. Then when you use my name, the blind shall see,
abantu babona ari we
wihumuye, and people will think it's you open their eyes.
Ariko mu byukuri ni njye ukurimo.
But in reality, it is me within you.
Njyewe
Jesus, when I'm still in the flesh, I preach to many crowds. But now, I'll sit within you. Then I'll preach through your mouth. I'll use my hands. I'll use your feet and your hands. For that to happen, you have to wait for 10 days somewhere. You have to be pregnant. You have to be conceived for the power to be born within you. You must be calm and quiet somewhere. You must be in a time of prayer. You must be in a time of worship. Then I will explode in you. People will see it and they will be amazed. When Jesus had said these words, on the 40th day he departed in their sight, and then they went and sat in the upper room. What were they saying? They were trying to remember the good stories of Jesus. You remember when we were with him? I would lie in his bosom. That would be John. Peter would say, oh, you had almost taken him by yourself. But I would go behind you and try to touch him. When Andrew had them, he would remember, I brought you all to him. So they went back to the stories of the experience with Jesus. They began to praise God. And they said, this man, I wanted to ask about this, but I forgot, and now he's gone. I wish he comes back, I would ask him more questions. Another one would say, I was amazed the other day. Remember that day? I knew it was over. When he went to raise Lazarus, I was saying, if he doesn't succeed in this, I don't know what is going to happen after. Imagine 10 days, a group of people seated together, no other business. They're just talking about stories. Let's give glory to the Lord. Chapter 1, verse 15. Let's begin with verse 12 for you to have a better understanding. Then they returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey. And when they had entered, they went up into the upper room. This is where they had had their last supper in the night when Jesus was betrayed. They were staying there. That included Peter,
Johanna,
James,
Jacobo,
John, 3,
Batatu, Andrea, bangahe,
Andrew, 4,
Filippo, bangahe,
Philip,
Batatu,
5,
Tommaso, bangahe,
Thomas, 6,
Batanatu, Bartolomeo, bangahe,
Bartholomew,
7, Matayo, bangahe,
Matthew,
Umunani,
8,
Jacobo mwene Alufayo, bangahe,
James the son of Alpheus,
9, Simon umuzeloti, bangahe,
Simon the Zealot,
10, na Yuda mwene Yakobo, babaga, bangahe,
and Judas the son of James. How many?
Numwe.
11. Where is the 12th?
Yitwa gande?
His name was Judas Iscariot. He had committed suicide. Now it is 11 disciples. The number of the government of God is 12. A 12th disciple has to come. For God to establish his kingdom, there must be 12 people. That's why God gave Jacob 12 sons. That's why Ishmael gave birth to 12 sons. That's why Jesus had 12 disciples. That's why the gates of heaven are 12. The government of God is formed around the number 12.
12
people. Number 12 is the number of the government of God. Let's see what's written here. Verse
14.
Verse 14, these all continued with one accord in prayer and supplication with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers. They were in the same room. When Jesus was risen, his brothers got saved. They were amazed. So really, our big brother was a God? And he immediately ascended to heaven, so they never had another chance. So when they were in the upper room waiting, the brothers also came and joined in, including the mother of Jesus, Mary.
Oh,
So all of those who had followed Jesus.
Muri iyo minsi Petero ahagaze hagati ya bene data. Urumva Petero niwe wari usigaye asa n'abari lideri. Ahagarara hagati ya bene data. Mwibuke ko abakristo kera babitaga bene data. Abakijijwe bakabita abakizwa. Bahurira hamwe kandi bakabita bigishwa. Nyuma niho baje kwitwa abakristo. Bene data, abigishwa, abakizwa, abakristo. Ayo ni amazina yose abakristo.
And in those days, Peter stood up in the midst of the disciples. Remember, before they were called disciples, then brethren, then believers. Though all these are and then eventually Christians. All these are named referring to Christians.
Muri iyo minsi Petro ahagaze hagati ya bene data. Umubare w'abantu bose bari bahateraniye bari nk'ijana na makumyabiri.
And in those days, Peter stood up in the midst of the disciples. Altogether, the number of names was about 120.
Peter arahagarara. Aha abumvisha ukuntu bagomba gusimbura Yuda.
And so he stood up in their midst and convinced them that they needed to replace Judas Iscariot.
Umvisha avuga kuri 21.
Look at verse 21.
Nuko murabo muri abo twagendanaga iteka ubwo umwami Yesu yarakiri muri twe. Uhereye ku kubatiza kwa Yohana ukageza ku munsi Yesu yadukuriwemo azamuwe bikwiriye ko umwe aba umugabo hamwe natwe wo guhamya kuzuka kwe.
Therefore, of these men who have accompanied us all the time that the Lord Jesus went in and out among us, beginning from the baptism of John to that day when he was taken up from us, one of these must become a witness with us of his resurrection.
Good. Barabahamagara muri abo bose Petero aravuga ati sasa dusigaye turi 11 babanye na Yesu kuva ku gihe cya Yohana umubatizi kugeza ejo bundi azamuze. None turebe mu babanye natwe nubwo batari mu mubare wa 12 duhitemo umwe nawe aba muri twebwe muri babagabo bo kumuhana.
And so Peter consults the whole group and says, let's look at the men who have accompanied us from day one and see, although he wasn't in the original group of the 12, let's find someone who can replace Judas Iscariot to become a witness among us.
Bahitamo babiri. Guhitamo babiri suko hatari benshi, ariko niko babishyisemo bahitamo babiri. Bahitamo uwitwa Yosefu ariwe Barisaba wahimbwe Yusito n'undi witwaga Matias. Barasenga bati Mwami Imana umenye imitima y'abantu bose werekane uwutoranije muri aba bombi abe intumwa ahabwe uyu murimo Yuda yataye akajya he. Barabafindira ubufindo bufata Matias nuko abaranwa n'intumwa 11.
And they proposed to Joseph called Barsabas, who was surnamed Justus, and Matthias, and they prayed and said, you O Lord, who know the hearts of all, show which of these two you have chosen to take part in this ministry and apostleship from which Judas by transgression fell, that he might go to his own place. And they cast their lots, and the lot fell on Matthias, and he was numbered with the 11 apostles. He became the first apostle after the first 12 apostles.
Undi wakurikiye ni Paul.
The other apostle that followed was Paul.
Nzakomeza mbabwira uko tuzagenda.
I'll continue to tell you some more details.
Mu gice cya kabiri twasoma.
And so in chapter 2 where we've just read,
Babiliya 12.
The 12 apostles
hamwe n'abo bandi bose bari kumwe nabo bari 120.
Together with the larger group that made a total of 120 people.
Ngo munsi wa Pentecost usohoye.
When the day of Pentecost had fully come.
Ngo bari hamwe.
They were with one accord. In other words, after 10 days, when Jesus had ascended to heaven, 50 days had been fulfilled from his day of resurrection. This is something powerful. They were all in one place. Nobody had gone out to buy food. Nobody had gone out on the streets of Jerusalem to look at the stores. Nobody was out to go on their personal business.
No.
They were with one accord. Because what was about to come had to touch everybody in the place.
utaraho ntiyagombaga gukorwa kuko iryo dirisha aho niyo hagombaga kumanukirizo mbara aho.
Whoever was not would not be in that place, would not experience what was going to happen.
Because that's what the Lord was hoping.
They were in one place with one accord. Remember the Tower of Babel? They all had one heart. They were all united. They had the same language. And they said, let's build a tower and go up to God. Remember that? That's Genesis chapter 11.
Nuko ku murongo wa kabiri ngo umuriri ubatungura uvuye mu ijuru umeze nk'umuyaga uhuha cyane ukwira inzu bari bicaye.
Verse 2, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting.
Haboneka indi miziga banigeze isa n'umuriro. Murabona ururimi rw'umuntu, ururimi niko icyo kintu cyaje kimeze ukururimi rw'umuntu rumeze ariko kakaga umuriro bakabona kare ku mutwe w'umuntu ukururimi rumere ariko bya iyo uvuga ngo indimi z'umuriro ngo ni ibindi bintu n'ururimuru uru donc ururimi rwaraje babona rwiteretse ku mutwe w'umuntu ariko rumeze nk'umuriro umuntu yarebe mugenzi wakarubona nundi yarebe mugenzi wakarubona nundi yarebe mugenzi wakarubona.
Then there appeared to them divided tongues as of fire, and one sat upon each one of them.
Donc ugo rurimi ruza kuri buri muntu.
It came upon each of them.
Ngo bose uwo mwanya buzuzwa umwuka wera.
And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit.
Ururimi ni semboro yikiyo kuvuga.
The tongue of fire was a symbol of speaking.
Batangira none kuvuga muzindi ndimi.
Now they began to speak with other tongues.
Ngo uko umwuka yahaye abantu kuzivuga.
As the Spirit gave them utterance.
Wumve. Listen.
They began to speak with other tongues. Everybody would speak a tongue. Charles would speak. He would speak. But everybody was happy, speaking a different language, but happy. Remember, this is something that has come from heaven and has come upon them and has indwelt them, appears on their heads, begin to speak in other tongues. At the Tower of Babel, God came down. They spoke other tongues. You remember that? They did not agree. But these ones, they were in unity. With the Tower of Babel, they scattered all over the face of the earth. Everybody began to build their own kingdom. This would be a chief of the place, another one there, another one a chief there. They begin to fight between themselves. But those who are filled with the Holy Ghost, they began to go everywhere. They also scattered. But they built the kingdom of God. They all built the one kingdom, the kingdom of Jesus. But those of the Tower of Babel, everybody was trying to build their own kingdom. They were trying to get their own mountain. They would find their colleagues dispossessed them of the mountain. But this one, filled with the Holy Ghost, they did not fight, but they supported one another.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's what distinguishes the system of Babel and the system of Jerusalem. The Babel system is the system of the world. But the Jerusalem system is God's system in the world. In Babel, they wanted to go up to God, but in Jerusalem, God came down to them. But when you see God within your own flesh, in your physical flesh, you will not find him, but God can come down to you. It is not our works that please God, but when God seeks us, then we respond to his seeking of us. And so in Jerusalem, they began to speak with other tongues that day.
Bibiliya ivuga ngo muri Yerusalemu ngo habaga abayuda b'abaturage b'abanyadini And they were
dwelling in Jerusalem, Jews, devout men from every nation under heaven. It was such a great coincidence. There was a great coincidence. That very day, Jews had come from all over the face of the earth. And other devout men in Judaism, because of the Roman kingdom, the Roman empire, those who had friends who are Romans, they had converted them to become a Judeans. They all came to Jerusalem to celebrate the Feast of Harvest. The Bible says, And when this sound occurred, their multitude came together and were confused because everyone heard them speak in his own language. In other words, these guys were speaking loudly. When you have the Spirit, you cannot be silent. They began to shout, speaking in other tongues. They were in the upper room. Those who go with us to Jerusalem, we've taken you to that room. Even to this day, that upper room is still there. When we are there, we sing, we praise God where David used to sing. And those who are in the upper room, they all come out to see us when we are singing. That's the way it was. They had them in the upper room. And you'd hear people singing in Kinyarwanda.
Praise Jesus.
They say, how can they be singing our language? They're speaking our language. This is what happened. Verse
7. Bavuga sabanyagariraya none se niki gitumye twese tubumva bavuga indimi ziwacu zakavukire sazindi zindani apana zigikoroni ururimi rw'indani ribavuga igifaransa n'icyongereza bavuga kakarimi kiwanyu niba ari umukiga bavuga igikiga nuba ruwahe bavugaga icyo kirimi kiwawe akuma umuntu arimba mu gikiga akavuga ati kavukire muranyuva neza.
Verse 7. Then they were all amazed and marveled, saying to one another, look, are not all these who speak Galileans? And how is it that we hear each in our own traditional language in which we were born? How can this be?
Traditional language. Rurimi rwiwa. Niba wari umunyarwanda uvuye hehe bavugaga muri ikinyarwanda ariko kiwanyu.
They would speak the languages that the people who were there would understand, like their own traditional language.
Birabatangaza
cyane. And this amazed them.
Ngo kandi bamwe akabo turaba pariti, turaba medi, turaba nyelam, turaba tuye Mesopotamia, Yudaya, Ikabadokia, Iponto, no muri Asia, ni Frugia, Ipamfilia, muri Egiputa, mu gihugu cy'Libiya, gihereranye ni Kurene, n'Abaroma b'abashitsi, n'Abayuda, n'abakomeza idini yabo, kandi n'Abikirete n'Abarabu, turabavuga bavuga ibitangaza by'Imana mu ndimi ziwacu.
Parthians and Medes, Elamites, those dwelling in Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya, adjoining Cyrene, visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, we hear them speaking in our own tongues the wonderful works of God. So they were all amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, whatever could this mean?
Others mocking said
they are all full of new wine. They just had nothing to comment. They said they are simply full of wine.
Petero yumvise bavuze ngo basinze. Peter bisimbye ihanganira na Yesu aranzi tukibana nawe nti ryamperagamu ndahagurutse Peter donc niko yarameze na Yesu aranzi ngo ariko Peter ahagarana nabo 11 ababwiza ijwi rirenga yari kuri etage hejuru yemwe bagabo bi Yudaya n'abatuye Yerusalemu mwese mwe ibi mubimenye kandi mwumviriza amagambo yanjye abandi basinze nkuko mwibwira kuko ari saa 3 ari saha ya 3 uyu munsi donc saa 3 za mu gitondo ahubwo ibyo murebe ibi byavuzwe n'umuhanuzi Yoweli ngo Imana iravuze iti uko niko bizaba mu minsi y'imperuka nzasuka umwuka wanjye ku bantu bose kandi abahungu n'abakobwa banyu bazahanura n'abasore banyu bazerekwa n'abakambwe babarimo bazarota ndetse n'abagaragu banjye n'abaja banjye muri iyo minsi nzabasukira ku mwuka wanjye bazahanura nzashyira amahano mu ijuru hejuru nshyire n'ibimenyetso mu isi hasi amaraso n'umuriro no gucumba ku mwotsi izuba rizahinduka umwijima ukwezi guhinduka amaraso uwo munsi mukuru kandi utangaje Uwiteka utaraza kandi umuntu wese uzambaza izina ry'Uwiteka azakizwa yemwe bagabo ba Isirayeli mwe ni mwumva ya magambo Yesu w'i Nazareti wa muntu Imana yabahamirishije imirimo ikomeye n'ibitangaza n'ibimenyetso ibyo yamukoresheje hagati yanyu nk'uko mubizi ubwanyu sinimo mvuga ibyo mutazi murabizi ubwanyu ngo ni Petero uwo muntu amaze gutangwa kuko Imana yabigambiriye ibimenye bitari byaba mwamubambishije amaboko y'abagome muramwica ariko Imana yaramuzuye ibohoye umubabaro uterwa n'urupfu kuko bitashobotse kwakomezwa narwo kuko Dawidi yavuze ibye aravuga ati uzaho Dawidi yarari muri yanzu yo hejuru yarahambwe munsi yayo na n'uyu munsi niwe igituro cye kiye kubwira umwisirayeli Dawidi ubu mubyuka ije wese abaranga mutima arabyuka kuko baramwemeye ngo na Dawidi yarabivuze iyo nzu bariho munsi yaho niho Dawidi ahambwe akoze ku ijambo rya Dawidi ati twumvuye umupapa ngo yaravuze ngo nabonye umwami wanjye ari imbere yanjye iteka ryose kuko ari iburyo bwanjye ngo ntanyeganyizwe nicyo gituma umutima wanjye unezerwe ururimi rwanjye rukishima kandi n'umubiri wanjye uzaruhuka wiringiye ibizaba kuko utazareka ubugingo bwanjye ikuzimu cyangwa ngo uhane uwera wawe abone kubora wamenyesheje inzira y'ubugingo uzanyuzuza umunezero kuko ndi imbere yawe bagabo bene data nta kimbuza kubabwira nshize amanga ibyasogokuruza mukuru Dawidi umuyuda yubye kandi Dawidi ati twumve neza yuko yapfuye agahambwa ndetse n'igituro cye kiracyari iwacu n'ubu yarahagaze hejuru aho buzuriye umwuka wera na Dawidi ari munsi yayo nuko rero kuko yari umuhanuzi akamenya ko Imana yamurahiye indahiro yuko izamuha umwe mu buzukuru be ngo be ari usubira ku ngoma ye yavugaga ibyo kuzuka kwa Kristo abibonye bitari byaba nicyo cyatumye avuga ko atarekerwa ikuzimu kandi n'umubiri we turakabora Imana yazuye Yesu uwo ariko Dawidi wanyu ntiyazutse Petero angari yuzuye mwimbaraga Imana yazuye Yesu natwe turi abagabo bo kubihamya guhamya ibyo nuko amaze kuzamurwa n'ukuboko kw'iburyo kw'Imana no guhabwa na se ibyo yasezeranije ari byo mwuka wera none asutse icyo mureba kandi mwumva kuko atari Dawidi wazamutse mu ijuru ahubwo ubwe yaravuze ati Uwiteka yabwiye umwami wanjye ati icara iburyo bwanjye ugezaho nzashirira abanzi bawe munsi y'ibirenge byawe nuko abo mu muryango wa Isirayeli bose nibamenye badashidikanye yuko Yesu uwo mwabambye Imana yamugize umwami imugira na Kristo nubisomeho dukwiye iri jambo ya konkrizo yagarukije ngo yamugize umwami na Kristo yari challenge ikomeye ku Bayuda.
This word which Peter said in verse 36 that God had made Jesus both Lord and Christ was a powerful statement to the Jews.
Yes, ari kwisi.
When Jesus was on the earth,
yitwaga Kristo.
He was not called the Christ.
Kuko Petero yaravuze ngo ni Kristo.
Because Peter had said that you are Christ, the Christ.
Kristo.
Christ.
Niwe asizwe amavuta.
Is the anointed one.
Kandi niwe abisirayeli bari bategereje.
And he's the one that the Jews were waiting for.
Bishe Yesu kuko bavuga ngo ari igereranye.
They had killed Jesus because they argued, he claimed he was blaspheming.
Kuko kuri bo Kristo ntiyapfa.
Because for them they thought Christ is not able to die.
Masiya,
the Messiah,
ariwe Kristo.
Who is Christ?
Masiya ni giburayo Kristo ni kigirike ariko zose ni bimwe nuwasizwe.
Messiah is Hebrew, Christ is Greek, but they both mean the anointed one. And so they said, now we've killed him. How can it be that the Messiah can die? They deceived us. So the discourse of Peter, For you as a Christian today, you are used to the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. But the Jews, to tell them that the Messiah was killed and was risen from the dead, was something very powerful and unheard of before. And so Peter was proving to them that he was indeed the Christ, and he is the Lord, has been made Lord by God. But David, whom they loved and respected so much, is still dead and buried in the tomb. I have no shame to tell you that David died and he is even still buried here with us.
Ariko Dawidi yari umuhanuzi yamenye ko Kristo ari we Masiya azaza agapfa akazuka kandi akajya iburyo bwa Data.
But David was a prophet. He knew that the Messiah would come and die and rise again and be seated at the right hand of the Father.
Abayuda bamenye ko Masiya yaje baramwica, byarabatanga.
When Jews heard that the Messiah came and they killed him, that shook them.
Masiya kwari wagomba kudutabara.
The Messiah was supposed to help us. How could we be such foolish to kill him? They were so traumatized. And what intimidated them? Was because they heard Peter and the group speaking in other tongues, praising God, Jesus, the Messiah, and that shook them. Verse
37.
Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart. They were cut to the heart. How can this be?
Shock.
They had such an incredible amount of shock. So David saying, my Lord, sit at the right hand of the Father. He referred to Jesus. Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Do you know what they were saying? Now we've killed him, he's dead. What shall we do? Can he accept to come back? Men and brethren, this has cut in our hearts. We are so regretful. What, how can we rectify this mistake? Then Peter said to them,
nimwihane umuntu wese muri mwe abatizwe mu izina rya Yesu Kristo ngo mubone ko bari gw'ibyaha byanyu kandi namwe muzahabwa impano y'umwuka wera.
Repent and let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. It's okay, what happened, happened anyway. But now repent for the remission of your sins. And then, what would prove that you have repented is to baptize you in the name of the man you killed. Jesus the Christ, we will immerse you into water.
Ufanye nawe amumasi ya mwishi nidugukuramo tuvuye ngo uzukanye nawe bati vwara muramo wabariwe.
By immersion in water we will be saying you have died with the Christ, the Messiah that you killed. By coming out of the water you have risen with him.
Ndagira ngo wumve ko umubatizo ni ikintu gikomeye iyo utarabatizwa ubutarinjira mu mahame y'ima.
Baptism is a very powerful doctrine. When you haven't done it, there are principles of God you are missing.
Ikintu ushobora kuvuga ngo ariko narabatijwe turashaka kumenya ko winitswe mu mazi ibyo nibyo bitu niyo siri bateme apana bya bindi bindi tukwinjize mu mazi uvemo tumenye ko wabatijwe.
Other people say, I know I've been baptized already in some other form, in some other fashion, but what proves to us is to accept to be immersed in water.
Eh? Reka tukomeze twumve uyu mugabo muramwumva namwe.
You can understand this man.
Ngo kuko isezerano ari iryanyu n'abana banyu n'abari kure bose abazahamagarwa n'umwami Imana yacu namwe muruzuri umwuka namwe muzavuga muri izindimi namwe muri ishima nkatwe isezerano ni iryacu namwe n'abana bacu n'abuzukuru n'abandi bose bazavuka.
Verse 39, for the promise is to you and your children and to all who are afar off, as many as the Lord our God will call. You can also be filled with this Holy Spirit and all the children who shall come later in the kingdom.
Ngo akomeza kubahamiriza n'andi magambo menshi arabahugura ati mwikiza biki gihe biyobagize.
And with many other words he testified and exhorted them saying, be saved from this perverse generation.
Iyo ruka yandika diskuru zose za Petero nkuko nazibabwiye ni 9 iyo zandika zose akavuga nti twatwarabonye ibitabo ariko yarahiniya ngo ababwire nibindi byinshi ariko akantu yavuze ngo mwirinda biki gihe biyobagize.
If Luke had continued to write all the speeches of Peter, we wouldn't have a lot of books, but he summarized here and says, and with many other words, and he testified and exhorted them, saying, be saved from this perverse generation. All the people who are there, there are some who are saying, yeah, of course, we know that. And others were saying, no, these guys are just trying to make up their own stories. And then Peter tells them, be saved from this perverse generation. Because those you're standing with are trying to deceive you.
But verse 41,
then those who gladly received his word were baptized, and that day about 3,000 souls were added to them. How many were in the upper room before?
120.
Now the new number added total is 3,120. Today as we speak, thus today is the day when the church started. That is when the church was born, that very day. That is the family of God.
Aha.
On that day, that's when God said, now I've got a family on the earth. The family of God on the earth started with how many people? 3,000. Understand this and keep it in your mind. The day the church was founded is the day the last day began. Which means the day they got filled with the Holy Ghost,
bagende baburira abantu bose ngo bihane ku isi yose
nitumara
kurangiza isi yose imperuka izahita.
They received a commandment, a commission to go to the ends of the earth to warn people to repent and to be saved. Once we have preached to the whole world, then the last days shall be fulfilled.
Statistiku irerekana ko haramoko ibihumbi bitatu atarumva ariko hari ama strategy menshi kugira ngo bumve vuba vuba mbere.
The statistics we have today show that there are about 3,000 people groups who have not been saved yet, who have not been preached yet, and there are strategies already now in place. People are trying to reach them as fast as possible before 2025. Now, because of technology, the gospel can find them in their rooms. Let's give the Lord the glory. Let's give Him glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bahoraga, kumurongo mirongo ine nakabiri. Bashishikariye iby'intumwa zigishaga bagasangira ibyabo no kumanyagura umutima no gusenga.
And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in prayers.
Number one, bumvaga ijambo.
Number one, they heard the word
ngo iby'intumwa zigishaga
in the doctrine of the apostles.
None bakegera ba Petero.
And then they would come to the Peter's,
you
who walked with him, what did he tell you?
Peter
would start the story and they would tell them how Christ was. That's how they were teaching the word. They would tell them how on the day of his resurrection he came to them surprising, and that pleased their hearts. And then they would break bread and share together and fellowship. They would bring their money and share amongst themselves, and the breaking of bread and prayers. They were listening to the word.
Communion.
They had fellowship.
Communion.
Holy communion.
Bakagira no guhurira hamwe fellowship.
They had also fellowship.
Na prayer.
And prayer.
Zari bintu bine.
Four things.
Share the word.
Sharing the word.
Share their possession. Ibyo batunze.
Gusangira ibyo batunze.
Fellowship. Gusenga hamwe kubana gusabane.
Fellowship.
Hanyuma no gusenga.
And then praying.
Bagasenga.
They would pray.
Bagasangira.
Share.
Bakagira n'ubusabane bakaganira.
Fellowship.
Hanyuma bakuvuga iby'intumwa zivuga.
And then hear the teaching. Share the word. And people love this so much. That was their daily life.
Bagasangira ibyabo byose ubutunzi bwabo n'ibintu byabo barabigaburaga bakabigabanya bose nk'uko umuntu akenye.
Verse 43, then fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. Now all who believed, they are called believers here, were together and had all things in common, and sold their possessions and goods and divided them among all as anyone had need.
Kandi iminsi yose bakomeza kujya mu rusengero n'umutima uhuye n'iwabo bakamanyagura umutsima bakarya bishimye bafite imiti ishama bahimbaza Imana bashimwa n'abantu bose kandi uko bukeye umwami Imana ikabongerera iki abakizwa. Donc en fait église.
So continuing daily with one accord in the temple and breaking bread from house to house, they ate their food with gladness and simplicity of heart, praising God and having favor with all the people, and the Lord added to the church daily those who were being saved.
Listen, the Lord added. Umwami Imana akagira gute akabongerera bakizwa. Donc iyo turi mu rukundo,
when we are in unity,
dusangira.
When we are sharing,
ijambo,
when we speak the word,
ya,
when miracles happen,
imana,
the Lord,
ngo, voilà, fite famille, wa mutinde uri hanze, muri famille yanje, abakizwa.
The Lord will say, oh wow, now I have family on the earth, and he will tell the people destitute who are outside and say, now you better join this family. And that's how God adds new people who get saved.
Genda nawe umva iby'intumwa zivuga ngo umwami Imana akabongerera. Iyo twakoze eglise muri structure irimo ugo rukundo irimo izo mbaraga abakizwa ni automatic.
When we have a church that is structured in such a way that is having power and sharing, there are so many people who get saved. And so in that century, in this generation of capitalism and individualism, everybody is looking at themselves. How can we create Acts chapter 29 for people to experience this love? This is how they used to do it in the past. Whenever a family got saved, they would bring their possessions.
umugore yagira ngo abijyane umugore umugabo yagira ngo abijyane umugore ati ukabijyana ndahukana
bikagumaho nyine ukajya gusenga ariko ibintu byawe byasigaye hariya twabigenza gute ni gute twa crea act des apotres 29 nu gufata aba bakene baturimo tukabakorera amakoperative udushinga duto duto bakumva gwa rukundo rw'Imana iyo niyo act 29.
The only way, because today when you get saved, it is not easy for you to bring your possessions because you are not in agreement with your spouse. But the only way we can do this is to be able to help those who have just been converted and create some cooperatives, types of cooperatives, so they can have some income generating activities. Because my Bible has told me none was poor among them. And the Bible said there shall be no poor among you. But our churches are full of poor people and rich people. The rich is happy to give you a ride, but not to give you their car. Because that's the generation we are in. They love that car. And they love God.
And they, family.
And they live in a family. And so we need to draw up a strategy so we can establish Acts 29. The first thing we do is to do the counting to kind of do a census to know how many poor people we have. We tried it here and you refused to give us data. We asked you to join the families. Tell us how much you have, your income. So that within your families we can be able to form cooperatives. But the people we had set up to collect data, whenever they came to, they said, wow, we got saved, we didn't have to tell you our income. At least we were able to know we have 4,000 members of this church who gave us their data. But they are fewer compared to 15,000 members that we have in this church. Without having real data, there is no way you can make projections except if you sampling. But we are not done yet. Because we love you, trying to come up with another idea. Because we want to help you come out of your poor status. Because we need to build Acts 29. When we start that, they will be added. Another thing the Bible said,
come
from their homes to the church. Especially they got the temple court. Because they had no large temple. In 25 years, remember in 30 years after this, that's when Paul was in Rome. But within 25 years, the church of Jerusalem had a membership of 250,000 Christians. The entire city of Jerusalem had a population of 500,000 people. So the entire half of the city of Jerusalem was saved. They were in the church. Of every two people walking in the city, one was the born again Christian full of the Holy Spirit speaking in tongues, another would be a pagan. Five out of 10 people, five were Christians, others were pagans. Why? Because the Lord was adding those who are being
saved.
You must know that God loves and cares for the church, and that's why he adds those who get saved to it.
There
are people who say, I am saved, I'm born again, I don't have to be a member of any local church. That is not right. That's not the right doctrine. The principle God says his family on the earth is the church. God loves the church. Just because you have issues with the pastor doesn't mean you don't have to be part of a church. If you don't agree with your father in everything, don't you still remain with the family? The church is the family of God. For you to live without a local church where you are a member, you are in great trouble. And you really grieve God. Because the joy of God is to add those who are being saved to the church. Did you hear the Bible said that the apostles added those who are being saved? It was the Lord himself. He added those who are being saved to the church. If you have no a local church where you're a member, I ask you to become a member of one church. If you don't want Zion Temple, look for a nearby church. Look for a nearby church where you live. In the plan of God, he created us to be part of the church. And that church is his family and our family. And in the church, there is love. There must be love.
No.
When you see a brother in the Lord who has only one piece of cloth every day, don't argue about it, don't talk about it, just go and buy another shirt and give it to him.
Utangira kubona bitangiye gusaza hari abandi hano batabifite vidura kabati kawe kuko birakoroheye kukabona kandi uha badafite kabati.
Another thing, do not store up clothes in your wardrobes until they begin to get weary. There are people who need those clothes. Just empty it and bring them because you can refill your wardrobes easily.
Icyo bakoze rero bagiraga amaselire mu mazu.
So what they did, they had home cells.
Kuko 250,000 nta rusengero zateranaga.
Because there was no church building that could be able to accommodate 250,000 people. So they would meet in their homes. Even when they came to the temple, they would meet in the court of the temple. Today they would say it is this family that is going to come there. When they wanted to do like a crusade or a meeting, when they had many sick people, they would line up the sick people along the road, and they would ask Peter to walk through that road, and his shadow would touch those who were sick, and they would rise up, and he would continue. Because they had no stadium, they had no church building. Where can you find a church building that could accommodate
250,000
people? The largest stadium is the Wembley Stadium in England, which has 100,000
sitting
capacity. Now imagine, where can you sit 250,000 people? That's why families are more powerful than the church building. You must be members of home cells. And even our church today, we need to revise our strategy of how we need to build our family. Because that's where we are able to know all the problems. And I encourage you to join a family. Because very soon we are about to come and see how the families are working. There are some who are really getting troubled because of this and others. A family should not be a burden over somebody. It should be a place where people express joy and happiness. Praise the Lord. Acts of Apostles chapter
29.
It is when we need to draw up a strategy that is going to help us have people who are not poor, help those who are poor to become better off. God will help us. So the Lord bless you. God strengthen you.
May
the Lord help you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Africa, yeah. cyawe